But now we're going to be moving on to the singles portion of the Tunes Tuesday Somerville Edition. If you live in the area, be sure to come to this venue. It's amazing. For just $15, you get to play a ton of arcade games. There's a pool table. There is a setup for chess and checkers, foosball. There's TVs where you can play all of your favorite games. From all the popular consoles.
Yeah, I've been playing like GTA before. Like, just a ton of great games. Yeah, I was walking around here.
Yeah.
Turtles in Time.
Turtles in Time. So plenty of arcade cabinets. They have pinball machines.
Oh, unfortunate death. I don't know why he did not be there.
Yeah. And it's not too far from Rutgers. I think it's only like 15, 20 minutes. So if you live, like I said, if you live in the area, be sure to come and check it out. There's not events here all the time, but when there are, they're a lot of fun. And it's, and you know, for what it's worth, you've got a great venue with places that are close to you. And yeah. Definitely come check it out. But here we go. We have Boar playing Mario, and he's going against Yuan, who was just in the grand finals of the doubles side of the tournament. So he's definitely going to be fresh and warm, you know, after playing all those intense games. But a beautiful cape.
That stock, that would have been impressive.
A beautiful cape, but Yuan not getting flustered, able to recognize what was happening and recover. And now Boar is finding himself in an edgeguard position. Weird hitbox on that up smash. It's not going to kill him. If it would have hit with the normal one, it definitely would have been the stock.
Yuan is just so good with that pressure. He's not giving him a second to breathe.
Yeah. And that back air is going to seal it out. Mario could not recover.
So Boar is so slippery with that Mario. He's just... looks like Luigi right now. Yeah, even rocking the green colors.
Yeah. But Yuan with an unfortunate self-destruct. Let's see if Boar can take advantage of this and push the match into his favor.
Enough all right, to break got up a 1%. That's all you need to get it started.
Yeah. That wave dash up smash. Almost killing Mario, but we are on Battlefield. And his DI was all right, so. Ooh. Hits him. He gets that one little percent before he goes out. But unfortunately, it's looking like a pretty uphill battle for him. Not impossible, of course. You know, we are in singles, so the comeback is a little bit more real, I think.
Ooh.
And Boar should have some experience playing with him because they did face off in the losers finals.
And just like that, great. Great offstage back air.
Probably something he was familiar with doing in teams.
You never know with Fox. It can go either way. You get one bad situation off the stage, and that's a stock.
Yeah. Ooh, what an up smash. Raw up smash. No, he wave dashed into that. Can't call it raw. All right, so Boar needs to just really focus on getting Yuan off stage. You know, that cape is deadly, so that's really all he needs. But he is going to get up smashed to death, and game one is going to go to Yuan. And this is winner's bracket. So whoever loses this match will just simply go into loser's bracket where they can try to redeem themselves. All right, so we have a switch to Falco from Yuan, and Boar is going to stay
Mario.
Capes him, but he still gets hit by the Sean.
I think Boar is dealing with the pressure a little better this time around. I think last time he got, especially in the beginning, he got a little flustered with, Yuan being up in his face the whole time. But it's looking like he's playing it a little more conservatively this time around, and looks like it's paying off so far.
Goes for a forward smash. A little questionable. I would have went for a cape because I think the cape clips just below the edge. At least I know in Project M it does, and that would have been a stock for sure.
There it is.
But the edge guard. No, the edge hog, rather. It's going to give Guar his first lead in the set.
Reflects the laser.
The back air will seal out Yuan's, I mean, Guar's first stock. Catching him with that forward smash. That was something that Guar seems to like to do. He likes to throw out a lot of those forward smashes.
I'm not seeing a lot of forward airs coming out of Guar, which I know a lot of top level Mario players are used as like one of the main kill moves. If he can get some down throws to forward airs.
Ooh, Randall almost getting involved in a negative way for Yuan. That could have been really, really bad if Guar would have been able to react. Right. But that forward smash, man, that is the second or third one that he's hit so far. So Yuan's definitely going to need to change something.
Good mash. Randall saying, nope.
Yeah.
You're on your own.
So back to even. Kind of looking like a questionable change to Falco. Fox seemed to be doing a little better. Maybe if Guar wins, we will see a change back. That tech is very difficult. The wall jump out of the up B, I believe, it's like one frame. So I don't even know if he would have been able to wall jump. I don't know if he was close enough.
Well,
read that tech into the middle of the stage.
That was a great recovery. I thought he...
Guar definitely with some good reads, but he gets hit with that Firebird, unfortunately. The shine, double shine off the top, and Yoshi Story's short top is going to seal the deal on that match. And we have a 2-0 victory for Yuan over Guar.